How you doing, sir? I'm Mike. Here's my car.
Yes, yes. I watch your YouTube channel.
Oh, awesome.
Yes. I used to
work right down the block.
Yes, exactly. How's everything going?
Thank God, you?
It's going well.
I understand you have some questionable vent piping.
Yes.
Let's go see.
And when we called somebody from like PSEG,
yeah,
to you know, we wanted to do like insulation and that stuff.
Yep.
Somebody had mentioned that the way that they did this hot water heater venting is not proper because it's not, it's like sloping upward.
Would you mind if I document this?
Yeah, no problem.
I don't include faces. No. In case you already, probably already see
yes,
that
yes.
though. Interesting. And it's a home, well, it's a Lowe's water heater.
Yeah.
Have you, did anyone put a level on it? You know, to see how perfectly level it is?
I don't know, you know, this came with the house and like.
How long has it been this way?
Since we got it.
How long is that?
I want to say he got the water heater like in 2018.
That many years?
Yeah, I want to say so.
And why is it now a concern for you?
Because when PSEG came in,
yes,
they brought it up to me.
And they said it's wrong?
Yeah. And then also I made a post on Reddit. There's a plumbing subreddit. And like there was like over 50 comments saying like, this is dangerous. You need to fix it right away.
The folks over at Reddit don't like me. I don't go on there anymore. There's a lot of armchair warriors, but... It appears to be perfectly level, and I notice you have a carbon monoxide detector right on top of the water heater, which, if it picks up low amounts, well, actually, you feel heat here, nothing crazy, but you could definitely feel something there, but a lot of times, I see that the, you know, the pipe insulation, you know, it comes with a piece of pipe insulation. The water, not the ones from Home Depot or Lowe's, but the ones that come from the plumbing supply houses. And you could see when the plumbers, you know, a short time later, all of the insulation is melted around the flue because of the backdraft or the positive pressure. Yeah.
I want to go get a...
So now, it should, you know, if I had a 4-foot level or a 3-foot level, we would be able to... get a more truer reading of this, but you do have slight pitch on it. Very, very slight pitch.
Okay.
I would like to do a combustion and draft analysis. A combustion is a little overkill, but if you've seen my videos, you know we do a combustion test on every gas appliance that we work on.
Yeah,
whether or not we're there for a low water cutoff or a zone valve, you know, I always believe in testing the equipment. But you do have a slight pitch on that, and it's in the right direction.
Okay. Yeah. Sure.
You know what? What could have been done differently here, and I don't want to be a Monday morning quarterback. Or Tuesday morning quarterback because it's Monday Night Football. You know, if this water heater was twisted just a little bit more this way, this could have been made shorter. Or you could put a 90 here and roll that like on a 45 and then pick this up to have more pitch. But you do have slight pitch. It's just that it's a like a 6-foot length from here to there almost, maybe 5 feet, where it looks long for that. But... We could do a combustion test and see. And then back to this low water cutoff light. This red light is coming on and off while we're sitting here.
Yeah.
So you know what that black thing does, the low water cutoff?
Yeah, like when there's not enough water.
It prevents the boiler from running. Correct.
And for some reason, I never have problems in terms of like the boiler not running. I don't know why the light...
See, it just came on again right now.
Yeah, yeah, it does that.
You probably have a defective low water cutoff. Let's just make sure you have water pressure in there. Let's see. Reading around 20 PSI. Where is the boiler feed valve right there? Let's just pump this up a little bit. Yeah, that light is still on. I wonder if this low water cutoff has the brass threading on the shank, or is it plastic? If it's plastic, consider yourself lucky, because they don't last that long. Yeah. Okay, that light is still on. We're going to have the homeowner put the raise the thermostat up, and let's see if it fires up. If it fires up with the red light on, it really has to go, because it's a safety component of the boiler. And it fired up, and the red light is on. Weird. Let's make sure it's wired properly. There it is. Look. They never wired it.
Oh, they never
wired it.
You know what it is?
What? So tell me what it is.
When I did the... I put it the Nest thermostat.
Yeah.
I had to put this thing in.
What thing? Oh, this thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, for two-wire application?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this...
It's been a while, so I don't remember if I did anything with the yellow wire.
Well, someone did something with the yellow wire. So this technically needs to be wired into the circuit. Now, if we can wire it to into the safety circuit, you know, the 24-volt burner circuit, so it'll break that. Because right now that red light is on. So let's just do a quick little test. All right, so we connected the, removed the red wire from the high limit aquastat. I have one of my yellow wire is going into there, and the other one put right there, and nada. So it looks like we have a bad low water cutoff, because there is definitely water there. Where's the power switch for this bad boy? Right there. All right, we are in a time crunch, folks. Customer's on a budget. We got to do the low water cutoff. We have to flush the water heater, change the anode rod, and I'm going to give us slightly more pitch with another adjustable smoke 90, all for under X amount of dollars. So let's get the show on the road. Let's open up the valve over there. That's our boiler drain valve. We're going to take our low water cutoff. I have a garden hose going all the way out to over there. Let's take out the low water cutoff. Once we drop the pressure, which is almost gone, almost gone, almost gone. Let's, not gonna touch the relief valve. Let's close that valve right now. Let's prepare our RB24. There's our RB24, the guard dog. Low water cutoff. This is the most popular low water cutoff for hydronic boilers. We're gonna put a generous amount of pipe dope on the threads. We do not use tape, ladies and gentlemen. If you read the manual, which many of you don't know how to do, but you can look at pictures, it does say do not use PTFE tape or Teflon tape on the threads, because you will interfere with communication. Now, we're going to do this with the quickness. What do you think, plastic threads or brass threads? I'm going to guess plastic threads. I was right, folks. You know what? If this low water cutoff took out the components of the boiler the way they normally do, this would be well over your budget, by the way. Okay. Here we go. It's like doing a gas valve on a water heater. A la peanut butter sandwiches. Look at that. Did that. We handled that with the quickness. Beautiful. Let's close that drain. Let's fill the boiler back up. And let's tighten up our threads. Beautiful. Right there. I didn't notice this before, but your automatic vent damper has been bypassed with a little wire. I would love to show you a facial expression right now. I really would. Here's your vent damper,
yeah.
Right? And this is what someone did.
Wow.
Yeah. You can't make this stuff up. And you know what? This is like the first real like epic fail of the heating season of 2025, 2026.
We haven't even started yet.
Wow. Cuz I went to wire in your low water cutoff to the red wire, which I removed from the high temperature limit so I could splice those two together, and then I noticed this. I'm like, "What's up with this?" Oh, man. Yeah.
Damper is the
that thing right there.
It opens and closes. Opens and closes.
Yeah, but
so
that
it's always open.
It's inoperable. It's wired out of the equation. Wow. Yeah. Well, it's a good thing no one who's watching this video knows where we are right now.
Crazy.
You know, like, I don't know how long ago this was done, right? But the vent damper died and someone wired it out of the equation. Right, just like the low water cutoff died and someone wired it out of the equation but gave the appearance that it was still getting power because it was still getting power, right? So now if we turn this power switch on, right, our red light, our green light comes on our low water cutoff and we good. So now if we turn that thermostat on, you have one zone in the heating in the house or two?
We just have one.
Okay, let's turn that on. I want the boiler to run. I want it to circulate that hot water, make sure everything heats up. Okay. Cuz I don't want to come here in the first cold day like, "Oh, you changed my low water cutoff and now it's not heating my house properly," you know?
Yeah.
So we're going to make sure it works properly. In the meantime, I'm going to drain the water heater and we're going to change the anode rod for you. So I just heard a click. Okay. So let this run. And in case you're wondering, folks, if you look in the low water cutoff manual, right, for the RB24, you will see on page 8, I believe it is. Where is it? It's here somewhere. Here we go. Right, page 8. Oh, page 6, I was close. Do not use PTFE tape. Use only pipe sealant. Failure to follow these instructions will cause the probe not to function as intended and could cause death. Death! Or personal injury or damage, but don't do it. Don't be a hack, right? Now you know. Pipe dope, okay? That works. Let this thing run. Let's hook up our drain hose from the bottom of this Lowe's A.O. Smith water heater. And let's change the anode rod, which is right there. All right. These piece of garbage valves. All right. Damn. Whole thing's moving. Keeping it real, it ain't coming out. Scratch that. I removed that elbow and that little piece of a 4-inch smoke pipe that was here. I put on an adjustable 4-inch 90, another 4-inch 90, and now we have flying pitch. Let's open this valve back up, stir up the bottom of that water heater, get all that junk out of there. It's
sad. I really wanted to replace an anode rod for him because I think I would have been on the budget, but it would be nice to get like 6 more years out of this bad boy, or at least a few more years out of it, but it is what it is. Let's get the combustion analyzer clean up and check our draft. Let me show you the water. It's probably going to be clear now, but look at that. Nice tint of brown to it. See that? That's nasty. That's metal in your water. Wow. Five gallon bucket challenge. Yeah, and he's got a water filter too, huh? Wow. You want to take a look at this? We really should plan on that anode rod replacement. Yeah, that's with a water filter. It's nasty.
Maybe because they never flushed it.
Maybe, but we'll let this thing flush for a little while longer.
Wow.
All right, since we touched it, doing a combustion analysis on the water heater. That sit for a minute, print the results, and then we'll do the boiler since we touched that too. All right, a little manual test of the low water cutoff, the boiler turned off, and release, and it clicks back on. And all I did was I broke the wire going or leaving the high limit control that was going to go then to the vent damper, or come for the vent damper, but I wired in those two limit yellow wires from that harness assembly. The power still is there, the ground, and R and C wide respectfully there. And this is for his nest. I don't know if they even gave him fake Wagos. And I didn't forget about the bucket, but I want to show you how much iron is resting on the bottom of this bucket. I want to move that out of the way, those little air bubbles, but look at all that iron resting at the bottom of this bucket. Isn't that crazy? That is nuts. That is absolutely nuts. No. But wow. Nasty. I did a great job. Identified multiple issues with the heating system. Wasn't there for that issue, but took care of the pitch on the water heater, which really should have been that way to begin with. I don't know what people were thinking. I really don't know what the people were thinking. Maybe they didn't have enough fittings. Who knows? So if you live in the Long Island, New York area, and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your plumber, you know what to do. Pick up the phone. Give me a call. 516-348-6300. Or save time. Book online at pipedoc.net. I'll catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.